moving taxation on severance pay on and several other issues as it relates to the performance of the current government. Right now in the studio, we have with us some persons who are here to talk about the death penalty, and some of them are from Amnesty International and from other associations. However, we have very, very little time, so there's a good possibility that they may have to come again, or perhaps I will have to do an interview with them after we wrap up, which we will play for you after. But one way or the other, we will be chatting with them. So what we're going to do, we'll take a break, and when we come back, we will start the discussion. And like I say, you would probably have to get the rest of it in a pre-recorded segment, which would be broadcasted as soon as possible, likely tomorrow or in the coming days. Let's take a break. We'll be right back on Spice Morning.
The momentum continues to build as government's open currency forum reaches a high point this week with back-to-back sessions Wednesday and Thursday. This Wednesday, St. George's Northeast residents gather at the Boca Secondary School to have their say. This Thursday, St. Patrick's East residents assemble at the Shantymel Primary School also to have their say. It's a people parliament where residents outline concerns and recommendations to the government. Prime Minister Keith Mitchell and MP Tobias Clement listen this Wednesday from 6:30 at Secondary School, and the Grenadian leader and MP Anthony Bolson listen this Thursday from 6:30.
Sometimes the simplest joys in life can be the most rewarding. For quality sexual and reproductive healthcare services, make the GPP your next stop. Visit our offices at St. George's and Grenville. Call 440-3341 or 442-5442 for more information. The Grenada Planned Parenthood Association, promoting healthy living.
Spice Morning. Before the break, I said to you I was going to attempt to start the interview, but looking at the time, Spice Morning wraps up at 8:30 every morning. We hardly have any time. And this discussion, it's a very deep discussion. It's not superficial at all. It's a very, very important issue. And so we need the time. So we will do, I will do the recording of the interview. In fact, I will do it right after 8:30. And we will broadcast it for you as early as possible. It's all about the abolishment of the death penalty, and I know it's something that you want to learn as much as you can about. I mean, we live in extremely challenging times, you know that, and often, you know, we wish that we can annihilate some of the perpetrators of some crimes we hear about, but it may not go down with everybody the same way. So it's an opinion that you want to pay attention to. Well, it's time for the talking points, and we are going to move straight into the talking points for today. We have something here. It says from the Grenada, from who is that from? That is from, it's all about, it's from the Grenada Board of Tourism, actually, the Grenada Board of Tourism. It's all about a vendor cruise workshop. It says, as the Grenada Board of Tourism prepares for the 2013-2014 winter cruise season, which commences on the 30th, 2013, or which commenced on the 30th, well, which commences, that is, on the 30th of October. Work is underway to ensure that all visitors to our beautiful Spice Isle have their best travel experience. As such, cruise briefing workshops for all vendors operating in declared zones will be held at the Public Workers Union Building on the following dates. On Thursday, the 17th of October, and that is from 9 a.m. until 12 noon, persons engaging in beach chair operation and assisting, beach bar food operators and assist water taxi operators. From 10 p.m. to 4 p.m., Zone 1 is going to be at Burns Point. Zone 2 is going to be on Melville Street. Zone 8, Fort Frederick. Zone 9, Annandale. On Friday, the 18th of October, from 9 a.m. to 12 noon, Zone 5 will be at the Grand Anne's Spice and Craft Basket. From 10 p.m. to 4 p.m., Granby Street. That should be from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Granby Street, Grenada Taxi and Tours Guides Association. Vendors in these zones are asked to make a special effort to attend and to be on time, as your ultimate risk for the success of your tourism business. And for further information, you can contact the Grenada Board of Tourism at telephone numbers 440-2001 or 2279. And so, yes, folks, let me just recap. For the opening of the 2013-14 cruise ship winter season, persons who are engaging in things like beach day operating and bar, food operators, water taxi and so on, the Board of Tourism, they want to meet with you to ensure that you are prepared for the opening of the season. Well, the West Indies were 28 for no in their second innings after gaining a first inning lead of 47 against India at the close of the second day of the second unofficial test in India. Craig Brathwaite is not out in 18 and Kieran Powell 9. India A were bowled out 359 in their first innings, and Jagadish scored 86, Nayar 69 and Kaul 64. Miguel Cummings has taken 3 for 58 from 25 overs, and Veerasamy Parmal 2 for 66 from 25 overs, Miller 2 for 90 from 31 overs, Uddin 2 for 22 from 14.1 overs. The scores: West Indies A 406 and 28 without loss, India A 359. Folks, you are on Spice Morning, and this is where we're going to wrap up for today. It was a pleasure spending time with you. I hope you enjoyed the discussions as much as I did. God's willing, we'll be right back tomorrow. Have yourselves a wonderful day.
You're watching the Government Information Service, channels 12 and 22.